It is the day after the storm. What storm? Ho, ho, ho. Only the biggest storm ever to hit California, ever. El Nino. There we go. Oh, good morning. Can you see my green mustache? I have my shake already. I'm having a cup of coffee. Sam Tripoli should be over any second now. I'm doing a podcast with him. Joey Diaz is coming over at noon. Oh, before we do anything further, I want to tell everyone to follow Tom Segura's new vlog. That's right. Tom Segura has a vlog, and he has an hour special this Friday on Netflix. It's called I'm Special or something. What's his special? What's his special? I'm Special. It's not I'm Special. Tom Segura Net Fat. It just comes up fat. Net Fat? No, Fat. God, no. Net. Put whale caught in net. Oh, dear Lord. Hang on. Tom Segura. Mostly folds. Mostly stories. Mostly cellulite. What's it called? Mostly stories. Watch Tom Segura's. Is that still green shit in my beard? I gotta wash my face before Tripoli gets here. He's gonna look like I sucked the golly dude giant dick. Watch Tom Segura's special, Mostly Stories, on Netflix this Friday. I think you can download it whenever you want. So download it Friday. And check out his new vlog. His link to his vlog is right. It's not anywhere, because I don't know how to do that shit. But he's editing himself, and that's the cool part. And it's fun, they have their baby in it. I liked it, I really liked it. Although he did take a stab at me, but that's okay. I think him got him back. Check out his net, whale caught in a net, Netflix, net fat, net, whale caught in a net, fat stories on Friday. Oh shit, it's Sam Tripoli. Oh,
ah! What are we doing? Oh, is this for your YouTube channel?
Yeah, my vlog. All right, we're doing a podcast. Priscilla, you're out, sister.
Priscilla, aren't you gorgeous?
Oh, I guess you're gonna sit in on this one. Let's just mess up. Don't hit him. Oh, here. Oh, you want this? Oh, why don't you have it out here?
So you do multi-cameras, huh?
No, no, no. So I'm obsessed. I'll talk about this on the vlog. I'm obsessed with vlogs.
Yeah. I just started one.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
And I can't stop liking bimbos on Instagram. And I, you know, I feel bad. I'm like, oh, I'm liking all these filth. You know what? I'm 40. I don't care. I like filth. I like filthy chicks who bend over chairs and be like, have a great Monday. And you just see their asshole. And I fucking love it. And I'm tired of apologizing. Ever since I started comedy, I've always been apologizing for who the fuck I am. I'm a filthy guy. I like being called the N-word when I fuck. That's who I am. That's who I am. I like being called the N-word. I don't know why this Mexican did it to me, and now I'm hooked on it, and it's a weird moment when you ask a girl to call you the N-word, but, you know, that's what I'm into, and I'm tired of apologizing. I like cream pieing. I like doing all that shit. That's who I am. I like liking sluts on Instagram, and I mean that in a kind way. That's who I am. I'm tired of it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Sam Tripoli just left. And guess who just showed up in the man cave?
That's right, you shit. With the stars of death. Two different kinds. I'm like Pink Floyd. Remember Pink Floyd pigs? Three different kinds?
Yeah.
Here's what we got. We got 125 milligram apples. Just in case you're having a day, you gotta go to church. You know what I'm saying? You gotta go to court.
Yeah.
Gotta talk to your probation officer. But just in case you wanna see the devil, then we got the 200 milligram stars of death. Three of these, you become a Nazi. Right off the fucking bat. You understand me? We got brownies.
God damn it.
We got more brownies. And we got, this is the hash that killed Lemmy.
This is
what Lemmy smoked the last night before he punched the ticket. Look at that.
Oh.
Ooh, that's how we do it. Cocksuckers.
Have you seen Star Wars yet?
I wouldn't go see Star Wars if you paid me.
Really?
I'm not into that shit.
You think?
Because when I came over from Cuba, that fucking, I don't like Martians, I don't like space, I don't like fucking robots, I don't like none of that shit, and I've never liked it ever. I'd watch TV from 6 in the morning to 6 at night. You know why I stopped at 6? Because Star Trek came on. Once that fucking creepy music came on, I turned that shit off. That's creepy shit, green people and all that shit. That's, you know, for me, it was always like, I'm Cuban. I'm a Cuban kid. I'm just trying to TV to learn English. What's Martians got to do with it?
Yeah.
Like, I was like, I'm not playing this fucking game.
You, you can't just slide that into life. Where's my phaser?
Yeah, fuck you. There was never any, fucking, you know, spaceships in my life. I just didn't like it. I don't know why some people,
People, it's funny. Some people do disappear, like the comic book type person. That happens, and then all their worries just disappear. Like, they serotonin out, and they're like, oh, they get immersed in it. Like, our friend was like, oh, no, I'm going Thursday, the day it opens, to see Star Wars. And I was like, oh, I'm not that guy. Like, lines and groups, and that fucking drives me nuts.
Did I ever tell you I was a comic book guy?
No.
Listen, when I got thrown out of Catholic school, I was forced to hang out in my neighborhood. And I hung out with these guys, Ray Canella, who worked for Sci-Fi TV for a long time. Today, Ray Canella owns a horror thing on YouTube. Dear friend of mine, we were in a band in the sixth grade. We sang Help, the album Help. But me, Ray's a nerdy guy. You know, he liked horror. And about six of us were just into comic books. So I got into the Fantastic Four and the Silver Surfer and all that shit. But we had two options. We could go into the city when I was a kid, like 11. Like, we'd say, fuck it, don't tell your parents, tell them we're going to something. And we'd go into New York City and go to a comic book place. But there was a guy named De Palma, and he had a comic book place behind a police station in North Bergen. He was like a 30-year-old nerd that lived with his mother, and he had invested over the years, and he had everything, Superman 1. And we would basically go there and rob him, like, you know, like...
That's what I love about you is your stories go from so sweet and heartfelt, and I'm showing you a small part of Joey as a kid.
He was such a nerd. He was such a nerd, and we were such nerds. But he was such a nerd that me and my nerdy friends were like, we got to rob this guy because he's too much of a fucking nerd.
You guys have a beautiful house, and yet you decide to come in here and mess with my stuff? Everybody out. Right now. That's not what I meant by out. All right, fantastic day two podcast. Now I'm going to dinner over at our friend's house. It's nighttime. Can you see that it's nighttime? I'm looking for transition shots. I feel like I'm not very good at transition shots. I'm just good at plugging in music. I'm going to try to use no music, just words this show. Vietnamese dinner with my wife's very southern father. Oh, this should be good. Dinner's been cooked. Everyone's eaten. It was a true, authentic Vietnamese meal. Am I right, Sandy? What was for dinner?
Salmon. Ribeye steak. Potatoes.
And potatoes.
I like
salad. Oh, no, salad. Benoit, you grew up in Vietnam. Is this what you guys had every
day for dinner? We're not that big, so we can't eat that much.
Oh, Jimmy, you're Vietnamese. By the way, I love that we sat the two people who could probably least understand themselves the most next to each other. Papa Jay and Benoit.
I think they did great today. Everybody.
Benoit, is there any point that you didn't understand what Jimmy said? Okay, let's ask Jimmy. Come on.
Jimmy, did you understand her?
Mostly. Hallucinated green light. And I slammed on the gas. My performance ain't perfect, but it's loud and it's fast.